Hey mathematicians, it's Justin again. And as you know, I'm getting ready for my first triathlon. Thanks to you, I understand the metric distances I need to trade from the last lesson. But now I've got a new challenge. Using metric volume to track my water intake and other important liquid measurements. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to name the metric units of volume, choose the best unit for different situations, and convert between these units using patterns, multiplication, and division. Have your guided notes ready, and let's dive into metric volume so we can stay on track all the way to the finish line. You might remember from our lesson on customary volume that volume is the amount of space something takes up. That's true no matter what system we're using. So let's break down the three main metric volume units that I need for triathlon training. The smallest unit we'll use is the milliliter. Milliliters measure small amounts of liquid, like a dose of medicine or a small drink. Think of milliliters like drops of water. Individually, they're tiny, but they add up fast. We worked with millimeters measuring length in our last lesson. What do you notice about the prefixes of millimeters and milliliters? Yep, they're the same. Milli means 1/1000th, so a milliliter is 1/1000th of a liter. That means 1,000 milliliters make up 1 liter. Liters are the most common metric unit for measuring liquids. Water bottles, milk cartons, and juice containers are often measured in liters. 1 liter equals 1,000 milliliters. So a liter is 1,000 times larger than a milliliter. Finally, we have the cubic meter. Cubic meters are used to measure large volumes, like the amount of water in a swimming pool. Think of a cubic meter like a bathtub or a giant storage tank, way bigger than a water bottle. 1 cubic meter equals 1,000 liters. That's a lot of water. Since there are 1,000 milliliters in 1 liter and 1,000 liters in 1 cubic meter, every time we convert between metric volume units, we'll multiply or divide by 1,000. Converting from a smaller unit to a larger one, divide by 1,000. Converting from a larger unit to a smaller one, multiply by 1,000. Time to put this pattern into practice. My coach recommended drinking 3 liters of water per day during training. How many milliliters are in 3 liters? We're converting from liters to milliliters, a larger unit to a smaller unit. So we multiply by 1,000. Pause here to solve in your guided notes. Three times 1,000 equals 3,000. That means I need to drink 3,000 milliliters of water each day to stay hydrated. That's a lot of water, but it's nothing compared to the amount in the swimming pool I'm at for training. I checked the information and it says the pool holds 200,000 liters of water. But when I researched the volume of competition pools, they're usually measured in cubic meters. Why do you think that is? A swimming pool holds thousands of liters. That's a huge number. Instead of writing out all those zeros, using cubic meters, a unit designed for measuring large spaces, makes more sense. Try converting 200,000 liters into cubic meters. We're going from liters to cubic meters, which means we're changing from a smaller unit to a larger unit, so we divide by 1,000. Dividing by 1,000 might seem tricky at first, but we can use what we know about skip counting and place value to make it simple. We can practice with a smaller number. If we had 200 liters and wanted to divide by 10, we could count groups of 10 until we reached 200. 10, 20, 30, 40, 180, 190, 200. There are 20 groups of 10 in 200, so 200 divided by 10 equals 20. Now, if we divide 200 by 100, we shift another place to the right because we're removing two zeros, just like how 100 has two zeros. So 200 divided by 100 equals 2. All right, back to the pool's water. We have 200,000 liters and we need to divide by 1,000. Look at the number of zeros in 1,000. Three zeros. Each time we divide by 10, we remove one zero from the end. So dividing by 1,000 means removing three zeros from 200,000. That means the pool's volume is 200 cubic meters. Using the right unit for the situation makes numbers easier to read and work with. Imagine if we measured a whole ocean in milliliters. That would be way too many zeros. During the triathlon, runners stop at water stations to stay hydrated. One station starts with 25,000 milliliters of water. That's a big number, so should we convert it to liters or cubic meters? Liters measure medium-sized amounts, and cubic meters are for really large spaces, like a swimming pool. Since we're measuring an amount of drinking water, liters make the most sense. So let's convert 25,000 milliliters to liters. Since we'll be converting from a smaller unit to a larger unit, should we multiply or divide by 1,000? We'll divide. Pause here to solve in your guided notes. What happens when we divide 25,000 by 1,000? Using the place value chart helps us visualize how the digits shift. 1,000 is the same as 10 times 10 times 10. That means dividing by 1,000 is like dividing by 10 three times, so the digits shift three places to the right. Each time we divide by 10, the digits shift one place to the right. Since we're dividing by 1,000, we shift three places. That leaves us with 25 liters, a much easier number to work with. The water station starts with 25 liters of water, perfect for refilling bottles during the race. We can always check our answer by multiplying to see if we get back to the original number. Since 25 times 1,000 equals 25,000, our answer is correct. This also shows us how conversions work both ways. So, what have we learned today, besides the fact that I should probably double check my water supply before race day? Well, now you know that milliliters, liters, and cubic meters are the main metric units for measuring volume, and that choosing the right unit for the situation makes measurements easier to work with. You've also practiced converting between metric volume units by using place value patterns and multiplying or dividing by 1,000. Be sure to complete the practice questions and extension activities that go with this lesson to practice converting between metric units of volume. And remember, mathematicians, in math, as in life, every effort adds to your success. I'll see you next time. Hey, hey.